be the cool kid in Sicily and not some naive tourist who blows all their dough and has a terrible experience, right?
So make sure you really listen to this advice and don't fall for the same 5 blunders I've seen a lot of foreigners make in Palermo. Pay attention till the end. Stay with me, here with me. There is no time to check out what your pal's up to on Instagram. This info will not only help you save coins and time, but more importantly, it'll make your Palermo experience way cooler and more local. So let's see these 5 mistakes you should avoid. Mistake number 1, trusting TripAdvisor. Sicilians don't ride on TripAdvisor unless they feel a restaurant really deserves a public lashing or crucifixion. It's tourists that mainly use the site. So when you're using TripAdvisor here to pick a restaurant, it's as if you are in China picking restaurants based on reviews written by Sicilians. Not the brightest move. So how to find out where the locals go? You gotta do it the old-fashioned way. Use your tongue. Word of mouth is still a powerful thing in this part. So ask your host, a local friend, the patron saint, Santa Rosalia, or anyone you might bump into on the streets, but don't use TripAdvisor or similar sites. Mistake number 2, not planning an itinerary. Sometimes I hear folks who visit Palermo proudly proclaim, "We are free-spirited adventurers. We plan nothing." Good! Go ahead! It doesn't take them long to realize that they are screwing up their trip. Palermo is actually an incredibly complex, bustling and vast city with one of the most extensive historical districts in Europe, with lots of attractions to explore and activities to partake in, not to mention the endless list of beaches to visit. Oh, there is also the charming little detail of no one speaking English, dodgy public transport and other pandemonium. All there without a plan? Good luck to you. You will spend your whole time there with your eyes glued to your phone, confusion and frustration, desperately trying to figure out what the heck to do. Don't do that to yourself. You wanna make the most out of your trip to Italy? Make sure you plan an itinerary. Mistake number 3, knowing nothing about the attractions. If I showed you this drawing, you'd probably think, what a crappy doodle. But if I told you that it was Leonardo da Vinci's drawing and told you the story behind it, you'd probably be like, oh wow, that's so beautiful. That's because observing a monument or an attraction, knowing nothing and without listening to its story, is like watching a movie without sound. After a few minutes, you'd be like, what the fuck is this? And you switch it off. Now, you don't have to shut down a Sicilian history book, but you should try to get the gist of at least 2-3 basic points. If you're feeling particularly lazy, find audio guides, hire a human guide, but don't look at monuments like, knowing nothing. Otherwise, you won't get the significance. It would be just a waste of time. Mistake number 4, thinking that here we only eat the street food and pizza. There are hot dogs everywhere in the US, but that doesn't mean Americans only eat hot dogs, right? Likewise, though tourist spots here are jam-packed with pizza, pasta, and street food, that doesn't mean that we Sicilians stuff our faces with it all day, every day. Sometimes I hear people go, Sicilian food is so heavy, only pasta, pizza, and street food. No, compadre. Padre, it's you who didn't take the time to investigate on what and where to eat. Sicilian cuisine is a downright taste fest, thanks to the global influences it's had. And actually, the major portion of our diet is made up of fish and vegetables. But of course, tourist hotspots don't showcase boiled artichokes or phallic-shaped Sicilian zucchini. Instead, they focus on the more attractive and, of course, heavy dishes. So if you want to make sure you truly experience Sicilian cuisine, do yourself a favor and do some research before coming. Mistake number 5, assuming that everyone speaks English. Give us Italians a brush and we will fresco church ceilings. Give us a piece of fabric and we will design the most fashionable dress of the season. But learning foreign languages isn't exactly our forte. Don't be like, we will make do, we will ask the locals. Don't rely on the locals to help you out. Don't get me wrong, they will try their best. But apart from the 50 basic words the locals know to give you some directions, no one's able to really converse in English. So what can you do to make your time easier in Italy? Try to arrive well educated about everything and ask for basic info like directions. That's it, so no slacking off, do your homework and create an itinerary before coming to Sicily. Ciao!